The direct effect of smoking is that it causes the artery lining. So arteries are like tubes, and the lining of those tubes is made up of a series of cells called endothelium. Those cells are sort of active in the sense that they allow some materials from inside the artery to seep through, and they allow nutrients to go pass back and forth through the arterial wall. When you smoke, what happens is that the arterial wall itself becomes roughened up. And to keep it simple, that roughening up of those arterial linings don't allow the natural nutrients to get back and forth through the arterial wall. Some of those nutrients are natural at dilating the artery and allowing it to respond to areas where the blood flow is diminished, and that's called nitric oxide. It's basically a naturally made occurring substance in the wall of the artery. The effect of smoking, at least directly, is that it decreases the elasticity or the ability for the arteries to actually open and close properly, and it also decreases the production of some of these enzymes and these chemicals that are in the wall of the artery, which allow for the healthy blood flow to be continued. After that happens, the smoking, cholesterol, high blood pressure, diabetes, all of these in combination affect the artery wall and create what's called plaque or cholesterol buildup. Those actually start underneath the surface, almost like an iceberg underneath the surface, and they grow to the point that they ultimately creep into the actual portion of the artery which delivers blood. And when that happens, those plaques can ultimately lead to significant narrowing or obstruction of the arteries, and that decreases the blood flow into the artery distal to the area where the blockage is.